This is the award-winning Lee Pitts Live.
Brought to you by the North Law Firm. For accidents and negligent security cases, call Joe at 239-337-1191. By Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers, where you can report crimes and get paid with nobody knowing your identity. Call 1-800-780-TIPS. By Solomon's Air Conditioning Incorporated. No matter what the weather is outside, have it your way inside. Call 239-693-1569. By Regions Bank. And by Lee Health. Southwest Florida, welcome back to Lee Pitts Live. Again, thanks for the accommodations here by First Assembly Cornerstone for hosting us for the next 6 weeks here on Lee Pitts Live. We have a thrilling guest here today. We get a chance to talk to the lady that makes it happen on the River District. Lisa Sbottoni, the president and CEO, is back with us. Welcome back to Lee Pitts Live.
Thank you. Great to be back, Lee.
Let's go right to it. What is the River District Alliance? You're the CEO and president.
The River District Alliance is the group of business owners, restaurants, bars, shops, all downtown. We represent them.
I was just down there eating. It's not called the Slopes, is it? What's it called? The kind of design like the restaurant design like outdoors. It's not the Slopes.
Lodge.
The Lodge. Yeah, yes. I keep calling it the Slopes. I love that
That's
place.
That's a great place. If you want a little bit of winter, go
Thanks
to the Lodge.
Thanks for saving me. The Lodge. Oh, man. And the owners there are just the great hospitality downtown. People will be surprised on the River District how many shops and restaurants and businesses actually exist. Give us that number.
There's several. There's hundreds of stores, restaurants, and very unique shops downtown. They're all locally owned. They offer a variety of locally owned products. It's just a great eclectic collection of businesses.
When you say locally owned and unique, is that by design or coincidence or just metamorphosis?
Well, there are no stores that you would see nationally.
Right.
I think we got Starbucks and Subway, and Subway is a franchise. And other than that, all those other stores are owned by our friends and our neighbors.
The transformation of the River District has just been spectacular. I saw recently in the news now the new hotel there has opened. What is that going to do also for the development downtown?
The new hotel downtown
Illuminary.
The Luminary is spectacular.
And the sounds is the
Calusa Sounds is now the new harbor side.
Mm-hmm.
And then they are also building an amphitheater that will be opening soon. But there's fine dining, there's LMAs, there's locally owned coffee there. It's just this beautiful, beautiful hotel that encompasses our history. Mm-hmm. Actually, that hotel, when they were doing the design, they met with local historians and they came up with a concept. So it really incorporates Fort Myers history and it mixed with contemporary, and it is beautiful. I hope everyone goes down and sees it.
Yeah, I'm looking forward. I think it's this fall that I'll take my television show there and I'll get a bird's eye view of the hotel from that vantage point as well. Now, 10-year anniversary of the Music Walk is upon us. Tell us about that.
Well, Music Walk has been an event, one of the most popular events downtown for 10 years. And this month marks the anniversary of Music Walk. It's a great, great event. And because of the situation of the worldwide pandemic, we're not going to be able to have a great Music Walk. So what we're going to do is we're going to celebrate that event in a different way. We're asking the public to recreate their favorite album covers, and we will post them on our new hashtag Explore Fort Myers. And we will, when we can meet again, we will post those album covers all over downtown. It's just a great way to honor music and to honor this event. We also have a Fort Myers Music Walk YouTube channel where we're asking people who have performed downtown to post their videos so that we could all see and recreate. And again, someday we will all gather again and we're going to have the best blowout, best music walk ever.
We cannot wait to gather again. Everybody's being impacted. What's all this I hear about the Great Pumpkin Patch.
We are going to do a pumpkin patch downtown by the Hall of 50 Seats, which will be at the corner of Hendry and Edwards Avenue, and the proceeds will benefit the Florida Rep. We're going to be doing that from October 17th to the 25th. I want people to come out, buy their pumpkins. We're going to have a lot of activity going on downtown. We're going to have these great selfie stations by the Hall of 50 States. So we want people to have a family event. We want to celebrate and have some fun.
That's an opportunity, though. The pumpkin patch is not as elaborate as the music walk, but it's still an opportunity to congregate in some sense.
Well, it's the opportunity for people to buy their pumpkins. That again is another locally owned company that is providing us with all different size pumpkins, and again it benefits Florida Rep.
Now I'm familiar with the Hall of 50 States, so you'll come up and park, get out of your car, or do you just drive around and do
No, you'll be able to get out of your car and it'll be a socially distant. We have a very large tent for people to protect the pumpkins. You know, pumpkins don't fare so well in Florida.
What are the open hours there when that would be taking place each day?
From noon until 7.
Okay.
October 17th to the 25th.
That sounds like a good place too, that the children can kind of see the pumpkins and
yes, and pick out their own and mm-hmm. yes.
The downtown. When we say the River District, the average person just think downtown proper central. But I've had different people on here who are part of the River District. It extends beyond just downtown Fort Myers. Can you elaborate on that?
Correct. The area of the River District is from Edison and Ford Winter Estates all the way to Oasis Grand Towers. And then it extends from the river all the way up to MLK, IMAG is included in that. So it is a larger area than most people realize.
What does a typical day, are you always working on annual things? Like if one thing closes, another one goes on. So what's a typical day for the CEO of the River District Alliance?
We have so much going on. Again, with the COVID, we typically do 50 events a year, being Art Walk, Music Walk, our great 4th of July celebration. But we've been forced to think a little different. For 4th of July, we weren't able to do the fireworks and gather together. So what we did was we hired the World War II planes to fly over all over the city, and they were all over the city, and that was very, very fun. So what, again, it has forced us to plan events or activity or non-event events for people to enjoy. Also, during the month of October, we plan on putting some very large pumpkin sculptures around downtown by some really great artists. We also plan to do some Halloween tricks or treats within our businesses, and we'll have it all listed on our website and on a map downtown.
See, the pandemic has made us all think differently. Mm-hmm. And the beautiful thing that's going to come out of this is some of those things that we've done uniquely, we'll be able to keep those and go back and use some of the grassroots things. So I'm already seeing in your eyes, hey, Lee, we thought outside the box, but this can work down the road. Can you?
Exactly. Well, so we can definitely do a pumpkin patch next year.
Right.
For the holidays this year, I plan on asking all the businesses to really do up their windows so that we could window shop and see. We're going to put more decorations downtown. We're going to do an adult elf on the shelf and put an elf in a different location downtown. These are all activities that people can enjoy without being all together from 6 to 10 on a Friday night. You can come downtown anytime and enjoy the holiday spirit of Halloween or fall or Christmas.
and we want to emphasize that all the restaurants and shops are open.
Yes, they are. I'm very proud to say that the restaurants and shops are all open. They have been supported by our local community, and I hope that people continue to come downtown, because as we said earlier, these are shops and businesses owned by our friends, our local, our neighbors, and they've been in business and they're having a hard time. They have supported this community throughout the years, and now we need others to come down and support them.
And you just heard me say, I just recently went to a restaurant. When I leave here, I'll be going downtown to eat again. And for what? I just love being downtown, sitting outside, inside, and it seems like the socially distancing concept is really in place as well. What is the shop small for fall campaign?
Well, that is, again, a campaign where you come downtown. We're going to have all different types of tricks or treats in the store, whether it's everything black is 10% off in the store that day, or you get it's we're just doing a lot of different specials, and I will again have that listed on our website. I'm hoping to get a candy corn teeny too. Or witch's brew. We're just going to think right again out of the box for different tricks or treats for downtown. Also, the one thing I want to say is that we also have a trail of pumpkins that are done by local artists that you could go into the different shops and see.
Give that website verbally. We have it on the screen, but go ahead.
It's explorefortmyers.com.
Explorefortmyers.com. Well, it's been a pleasure getting you back here on the show. Want to continue to let you keep us updated as our River District continues to thrive and flourish as a centerpiece for the city of Fort Myers.
Thank you, Lee, for all your support.
Keep up the good work. As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like Lisa and all the fine people who are associated with the River District who are doing it.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, Southwest Florida. Thanks for watching Lee Pitts Live. Of course, I'm Lee Pitts. I hope you enjoy that particular show. But you can always catch us here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button down there. That way you can get your Lee Pitts Live on demand when you want it and how you want it. We also encourage you to watch our show on Fox 4 and connect with us on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live.